Probably the biggest news was Buffett and Charlie Munger. And what did they, how do they feel about Bitcoin?
They don't like it. And they've been very consistent over time at finding increasingly pejorative language. At the Berkshire Hathaway annual meeting, mm-hmm. Buffett said that owning Bitcoin was rat poison squared.
Squared, that's the key.
And rat poison squared. And Charlie Munger said that trading cryptocurrencies is just like dementia. Mm-hmm. And they don't see much of a role for this. Buffett has always said that he doesn't like to invest in what he doesn't understand, and it seems that he's sticking to that with the cryptos.
But they're comfortable commenting on what
yes,
they don't understand,
right? Yes, they're
comfortable
trashing it.
So talk to us, we were talking a little bit about some of these new coins and what some of the developments there.
One of the more interesting classes are the so-called stable coins, where people are trying to create coins that replicate real assets or real currencies in the economy. So there's something called Tether that's been in the market since the middle of last year. And a Tether is supposed to keep a fixed value of $1 per Tether. And there's another one now called Basis that has a similar objective. It wants to be stable, really as a substitute for the US dollar, but a somewhat different trading strategy in the background that's meant to keep the value stable.
So buy it when it comes below a dollar, sell it when it goes above a dollar, and just keep it. It's almost like the Bank of England trying to support the pound at a certain level.
It's exactly what central banks do to try to peg the value of their currencies to one another. Mm-hmm. So you may remember a few years ago, the Swiss central bank put a ceiling on how much the Swiss franc could rise against the euro. For years, the Hong Kong central bank has pegged their currency to the US dollar.
Doesn't that always end poorly?
There are famous episodes like in Argentina in the 1980s and 90s. They ran what was called a currency board to try to fix the Argentine peso to the dollar. Eventually, you run out of money.
To support
if you make a commitment that we'll buy as many as we need to, sooner or later, you need to buy more than you can afford. And these things tend to collapse and end rather badly. Now, the guys at some of these crypto coins, and there's actually quite a few of the stable coins now, they claim to have algorithmic strategies that will execute themselves automatically. And you know, I think these things often work under normal market conditions. But when conditions get extreme, there's a lot of volatility, a lot of underlying movement in the market. That's sort of when you need the stability the most, but when people are least likely to be able to afford it. So it's far from clear. We'll need a long period of time to see if these things really can hold their value. But this is the marketing pitch. That they see a need for these kinds of tokens to provide liquidity and just a benchmark for other things to go against in the crypto economy. And so there's been a lot of enthusiasm for this. Some people are trying to tokenize gold, or you could think about doing this even for shares of stock or many other currencies besides the US dollar. So this might turn out to be an interesting market space where you can replicate existing assets, but get out from under the ordinary regulatory burden that comes with owning and distributing them to customers.
So once again, highly recommend if you have time. It's called The Crypto Economy. Great interview. And this idea of stable coins, I think, is the future. I've already seen in other articles, too, where they're thinking that the future for this year is going to be basically asset-backed cryptos. So obviously, we have Tether, and it's backed by the US dollar, and Venezuela tried to create a cryptocurrency, which if you're in the United States, you can't even buy, but they wanted to back it on oil. And I did share another video where one of the guys on Shark Tank is actually trying to create a SEC-friendly and regulated real estate coin, which is backed by real estate. And if you have been following my channel, one reason I do this because I obviously have not got a dime from YouTube. There's like a backlog or something like that for these videos. But my main interest is to do networking and to eventually create real estate coins on my own real estate investments and use that capital to continue to buy real estate and possibly do the same thing. If other people do develop a real estate coin, I would be very, very interested in possibly investing in stuff like that where it is asset backed so that if whatever happens and they liquidate, you know, in order to take control of that share, it would have to go through obviously, you know, for the title to pass on the real estate, you know, the coin need, you know, the coin or whatever need, would need to be bought or bought back. So I really think that this is the future, and watch out for this stuff in the news. I still think there's maybe a year or two of, you know, regulations and development before we get there, but a lot of opportunity there. And if you haven't had a chance and you're also interested in real estate, definitely feel free to add me on Instagram. I left my Instagram there. And in the future, if you got real estate deals or you got any questions about real estate, I'm very, very interested in collaborating with people that want to combine cryptocurrencies with real estate. That's like my main interest. But like I said, I still feel like it's a year or two away before anything can be really set up and before it really can be taken advantage of. So let me know your thoughts on this video. Like I said, it's not as entertaining as the fast money stuff, so I'm sure like half of you guys already fell asleep or turned this off and went on to another video. But I'm going to continue to share as much as I can of this interview. Just a lot of stuff to learn, and I'll give you my comments and let me know what you guys think, and I will talk to you guys soon.